Oh, Rob Pierce here, doing another video for a Coyote Gather. This is 2020. I thought I'd do a little different than before. I'm not going to put music on this one, and there's a lot more video, little short clips of video. So you can kind of use your mind's eye and your imagination to what you see in the photos. The other thing about this one, I came in with Kevin Longus from Glacier on Saturday. We rode across, picked up cattle in Baker Creek area, took them over to Sanger, and then went with the rest of the crew from Sanger over to Onion Valley. And then the next morning, Kevin Longus, Nikki Brown, and I, we went to the front. So there's not a lot of pictures of other people. There's more of cattle and of just Kevin and Nikki. There's a few other people in there. You look, you'll see them. Also, my old horse, I think he's made his last coyote trip. He stumbled a lot going in. He stumbled a lot this time. Fell down twice on the trip in and once on this trip out. And I have a tendency to think I'm still 20 something and I push him too hard. So he had an okay trip, but I think it's his last. That's him in this picture. We're loading up, or excuse me, unloading down at the Arrow Barren Ranch, getting ready to go before we started. Ronnie hauled Kevin and I up to the Glacier trailhead and off we went. It was a good trip, but I'm glad to be home. So hope you enjoy this video. And like I said, it's a little different than ones I've done in the past. I have a couple commentaries later on through the video as well. So enjoy. This picture is of Jorge. He's one of four Peruvian herders that Nick had on the cow drive this year. And the other guys' names are Roberto Lenner and Emmer. I hope I got their pronunciations correct, but I've known Roberto and Lenner for quite a while, a couple years at least. And Roberto, I can speak to him. He speaks English, but the other guys, they don't speak much English. But I would really like to be able to visit with them. I think it's an amazing story how they get to this country. There's a U.S. Agriculture Workers Program. I forget the exact name of it, but that's what they come here in. And think about it, coming from Peru and the Andes and ending up in this country, chasing cattle around coyote. It's pretty interesting, kind of a cool story. I like working with them. Like I said, I know Roberto and Leonard a little better than the other ones. They're all really hard workers, and it's to me, it's a really cool story how they got here, what they're doing. And I know if they pack me up and sent me over to Peru and turn me loose in the Andes to help herd over there, I wouldn't be much good. But these guys adapt, and it's really fun to work with them. This is a picture of Jumper. He's the horn steer in the middle there. The last couple years that I've gone in and out with the cattle, he's always been up front and most often the very lead animal. I kind of like the old dude. But this year, old Jumper, I don't know what his deal was. Coming out, he kind of took the scenic tour a couple times and took some cattle with him, and he wasn't being a good steer, but I'm convinced he just didn't want to come out. I know sometimes when we had our cattle up in the mountain, we used to be able to stay longer than they do now. And when the season was getting cool and stuff, a lot of the cattle just come out on their own. And I think Jumper was being the other way. He's thinking us stupid humans, just leave me up here. There's green grass, warm, there's no bugs. But anyway, once he kind of got in the groove of things, he got back towards the front, and Dick Longus was down there on the Keogh's Hot Springs Road where the cattle were crossing, and he said Jumper was the first one through the gate. So I like that old steer. He's kind of cool.
You can't go that way. Go! Up.
Ah!
Hello, hope you enjoyed the little video I put together. I thought I'd have just a few little comments after watching it myself and after being home a couple of days. I often come off these trips I've gone in three times and come out twice the last 3 years, and I find myself a little bit melancholy and kind of down in the dumps for a variety of reasons. And it's not important, but I'm glad I got to go. It's been fun. I went a lot through my high school and college years into Coyote. I went with Connors and Ira Barons, and then we had our own ranch, and I went in with that. And then I took a 34-year hiatus from going into Coyote with cattle. And like I said, there's quite a few reasons for that, and they're not important to anybody but me. I'm glad I got to do this, but I have to say things have changed so much. I think I miss a lot of those old guys we used to ride with and the way we did things. Can't stop progress, I guess. There's two things I'd like to talk about that happened on this trip that were kind of interesting. I was coming out of Baker Creek with the cattle that first day, and there was I ran into several groups, mostly ATV people. And they wanted to stop and visit, and they ask all kinds of questions about the cows and what you're doing and why they're up there and everything you can imagine, all things that seem kind of logical to me. But I forget how disconnected people are from agriculture. But the one thing that was kind of interesting is one of the women, she said, well, how do you know where they are, or how do you find them, or how do you know where they go? And trying to explain that's a little harder than I thought. But you know, when you've been up there a lot of years, you just know where cattle go. And you can track them, and you know, they just certain places that cows go. And she wanted to know how you got them out, and it was kind of fun talking to her. But it also points out how different our society has become. There's just darn few people that work in agriculture. And the second thing I'd like to talk about happened at the end of the drive when we're crossing Keogh's Hot Springs Road. We have to stop cars on both sides and let a few cows go through, and then there'll be a break in the cows and you can let a few cars go. It's amazing the amount of cars go up and down that road. But one lady pulled up. She says, do you mind, she said something to the effect, can my daughter have her picture taken with your horse? And I said, I don't care. And then she said, would there be a way she could sit on the horse? And I often forget, you know, I run up and down that mountain. I ride every day. I don't think about how cool it is to see a horse. And that girl got on, I helped her get on. My legs were a lot longer than her. And she sat up there and her folks took a picture. And then she got off and I watched her. She was stroking Cat's muzzle. Just, I wonder what her thoughts were. But they offered to pay me $40 for that, to let her daughter sit on a horse and take a picture. And I wouldn't take it. But I hope that memory was good to them. That might have been Cat's best contribution to the whole cow drive. Like I said, he stumbled and fell a lot on this trip. The poor old booger. I see him as a 5-year-old gelding running around. We were getting ready to be a reining horse, and I see myself, like I said earlier, a lot younger than I am. But anyway, that's all I have to do. Like I said, I hope you enjoyed that video. I thank Nick Atchaveri for letting me go along. I finally got a ride with Kevin Longus. Rode a lot with his dad when we had our ranch, but never really got to spend any time with Kevin. That was fun for me. And coming out with Nicky's always good. So that's about it, folks. Might not ever do another one of these. Take care, and that's it.
Texans are gathered up in Colorado. The kid, the fast gun, ain't with them today. The cowboys are riding tall in the saddle. They shoot from the heart with the songs that they play. There's a right handsome woman on up around Boulder. They got slick hardwood floors and a pot-belly stove. She swears I am someone that she can't believe in. She's the best Colorado gal I've ever known. We are the cowboys. poor boys, the true sons of freedom. We are the men who will get the job done. We're picking out our words so we don't have to eat them. We're rounding them up and riding them home. Cowboys are average American people. Texicans, Mexicans, black men and Jews. They love this old world and they don't want to lose it. They're counting on me and they're counting on you. The world will breathe easy when we stop the bleeding. The fighting will end when all hunger is gone. There are those who are lying, so we'll all have to lead them. It's everyone's job till we get the work done. We are the cowboys, the true sons of freedom, freedom. We are the men who will get the job done. We're picking our words so we don't have to eat them. We're rounding them up and we're